She's real fine, my 409. She's real fine, my 409, my 409. Well, I save my pennies and I save my dimes.
Giddy up, 409.
For I knew there would be a time.
Giddy up, 409.
When I would buy a brand new 409.
409.
Giddy up, giddy up, giddy up, 409.
Giddy up,
409. Giddy up, 409.
Giddy up, 409. Nothing can catch her, nothing can touch my 409. 409.
Ooh, giddy up, giddy up.
Ooh, giddy up, giddy up.
Ooh,
giddy up, giddy up.
When I take her to the drag, she really shines.
Giddy up, 409.
She always turns in the fastest time.
Giddy up, 409.
My four-speed dual quad positive traction,
409. 409.
Giddy up, giddy up, giddy up, 409.
Giddy up, giddy up,
giddy up, 409. Giddy up, 409.
Giddy up, giddy up, 409. Nothing can catch her, nothing can touch my 409. 409, 409.
We're standing here at the York Muscle Car Reunion. This is the owner, Larry Brinkley. So how did you find the reliable car here?
At the Randolph Swap Meet.
Randolph Swap Meet. What year was that you got her?
83.
Did you know the car when you got it, or when you saw the car?
Well, the kid that owned it had a Hot Rod magazine open on the seat, claimed it was a car, but it couldn't prove. So then went over to his house two or three times over in Lodi, where he lived.
Okay.
Looked at it. I talked to Dave Strickler. He was still living there.
Right.
He verified the car by VIN number, told me some things to look at it before he verified it.
Jeez.
And things were still there, so I wound up with it.
And now, it has an original motor in it that was erased? Now, how'd you track that down?
He told me. Grunts showed me different things on
kidding.
Yeah.
Boy, what a jewel that you found. You probably didn't even know. A lot of people walked by, didn't even know what it was.
No. And, you know, I told the kid I don't want to buy a pig in a poke, you know.
Right.
I had a 409 car at the time.
Oh, okay.
So I said, I don't need two of them, you know.
Boy, you're glad you bought this one,
yeah.
Then, huh?
Yeah.
And that was, and when you restored, how long did it take you to restore the car?
About a year, year and a half.
So you got it done pretty quick.
Yeah, there wasn't nothing I didn't have a part on. Any windows out, interior, the doors off, full front end, this is an Asia part.
So this is exactly how the car was when Strickler had raced it.
Yeah.
Back in the one, what national events did he win with the
62
car?
62 and 63 Winter Nationals.
And the Winter Nationals out in Pomona.
Yeah, yeah.
Boy.
Not counting everything local and
right, that he did.
All the other strips, you know.
So Dave never got to see the car complete.
No,
right?
No. He knew I had it, was working on it. When he died, then me and Susie kept working back and forth with it.
Okay. Yeah, pretty cool though. I know I seen Larry Davis around here with a bunch of pictures of the car.
Yeah,
as it kind of grew up in the stages.
I offered it back to Susie if the boys wanted it.
Oh, really?
Before it got finished.
Right.
She said, no, they're into Camaros. They don't care about the big, dual big cars.
Old big cars.
And this is Susie's favorite car.
Oh, yeah.
But everybody, all the old big crew, this is their favorite one.
Oh, sure.
A couple of them walking around here today.
Oh, okay.
One, just give me some more pictures of back then of it.
Yeah. Now, if you, I know that Grumpy took it down the track over at Quaker. Is it carving down the track since then? Or?
No.
Man, oh, this is going to be bad. Yesterday's runner-up and last year's winner. 38 out of 35, but Mr. Wright continues to give his life present. All right, we have Greg Jacobs in the 65 Belvedere. The red one, that's in Jake's automotive car down into the 1065. And we have
that's Bill Hooper, the back of the fire, the 64 Plymouth Belvedere, powered by the 440 Chrysler.
All right, Mike.
Hey, Richville in East Liverpool, Ohio, the Mr. Security in Impala, powered by the
sidearm red light will not show up on the Christmas tree, but Rick left a little quick. But on a 10:55, what the next round? That's the big Pontiac, holding the Pontiac flag.
All right.
And it looks like he will be King of the Hill, competitors next. Once again, we do need the FS Car competitors in lane number 13. FS Car, lane number 13.
Took it down the track at Quaker. What did he say after he drove it?
I rode up to, you know, a tower with him. And I got out, you know, got out. He had his little hat on, his cigar,
yeah.
You know.
Oh, yeah.
I got out, started to roll the window. He said, "What are you doing?" I said, "Roll the window." "Nah," he said, "it gets hot in these old cars. Keep the window down. I ain't gonna break no records today." So then he made a pass. He told me, he said, "You go back to my van. Watch it, nobody takes anything."
Yeah, right.
So I went back. He didn't come back for probably 20 minutes.
Oh,
I knew he, you know, no trouble on the track with it.
Yeah.
So then he finally come back. Bill had owned the track at the time. Was there with him waiting when he come back. He said, "Oh man, where you been?" He said, "Oh," he said, "I got lollygagging on the way back, signing autographs and having a good old time."
Oh, how cool.
Yeah. Dave told me when I was looking at it, he said, "Look on the dashboard, right above the steering wheel, see if there's two dimples where somebody got underneath with a punch and was going to punch holes in the back." He said, "I started to and then I got cold feet. The dimples are there."
No,
it's got the blue radio plate, so
right.
Aqua, because they pulled this off showroom floor. Because the one they had ordered to race didn't come in time for Indy.
Right, yeah, because they needed to get it. So
they pulled the radio out. It's still, he said, the heater lever should be in it, but no cables or nothing like that. The heater or anything, but he said, didn't have time to take the levers off.
Susie Strickler, the daughter of Amon R. Smith. By the early 1960s, the dealership had adopted the old reliable slogan. Eventually, Amon R. Smith, with direct Chevrolet backing, began to sponsor Dave Strickler's race cars. With Bill Jenkins tuning the old reliable race cars and Dave driving them, they became a household name in drag racing. Here is the Strickler family standing in front of the first three old reliable race cars, all driven by Dave Strickler out of York, Pennsylvania.
He said, did you look at the key? I said, I had it in my hand. I said, stand over the car, everything, looking at it. I said, I even moved it in the kid's driveway. But I said, I didn't pay attention to the key.
Yeah.
He said, it should have big number two stamped on it. Because I would have been nationals. They had this car, and the other 62, plus all their tow vehicles.
Okay.
He took all the keys and threw them in a cigar box. And so he was up for eliminator run. He's fumbled around trying to find the key.
Key for it.
And almost missed eliminator run. So when they got back home, they stamped each key with the car.
And check out Dave's grandson behind the wheel of the 62 409. And here is Mike Strickler pulling out his dad's famous 62 409. And each year, Larry is nice enough to let one of the Strickler boys drive out the old reliable. This year was extra special as Mike Strickler drove out with his mom, Susie Strickler, sitting in the passenger seat. Larry's best friend since growing up is Larry Davis. These two have been car buddies for over 50 years. They built model cars and real cars together. Larry Davis is no stranger to drag racing. He is the successful author of Superstock, Drag Racing the Family Sedan, Gasser Wars from 1955 to 1968, and Quarter Mile Muscle. This year, it was Chad Strickler's turn to pull out the old reliable with his son in the middle and his mom, Susie Strickler, riding in the passenger seat. Unfortunately, Dave passed away on June 6, 1985 of a massive heart attack. However, I know he is smiling down as his family is driving one of his most famous race cars. Oh, each year at the York US 30 Muscle Car Reunion Show, Dave's son, Mike Strickler, brings an outstanding display of all the old drag racing memorabilia still in the Strickler family. Most drag racers from the golden era of drag racing never kept much of their team shirts or posters. Dave Strickler was the exception. As you can see, the Strickler family has held on to most of Dave's personal items. Dave Strickler went on to set several national records and win the Super Superstock national title at the 1962 NHRA US Nationals with his white 409-powered Chevrolet Bel Air, the old Reliable 2. Overall, Dave won 16 national class championship titles in NHRA and the American Hot Rod Association. Also, Dave set 41 national and world records.
Now, Larry worked at Ewing Chevrolet in Canton, Ohio for how long?
42 years.
42 years. So you've probably seen some cool stuff coming and going.
Oh, yeah. I drove, you know, when these were brand new.
Yeah. What was that like at night when people were cruising through and you were working in the parts shop? A lot of guys coming to get stuff?
Yeah, we sold a lot of performance stuff at night.
Yeah.
I worked at night shift from the day it opened to the day it closed.
No kidding. And what a shame, because Ewing Chevrolet has since now been closed. So.
Here's a picture of the old Reliable sitting outside Ewing Chevrolet in Canton, Ohio at one of their car shows. In the year 1962, Chevrolet produced 15,019 Chevrolet 409s. However, there is only one 1962 409 driven by Dave Strickler and tuned by Bill Jenkins.
Larry Brinkley doing the driving. Larry is from Hartville, Ohio. Larry has run the car in the Field of Dreams. Couldn't make it yesterday. He's here just to give you another trip back in nostalgia. Of course, Dave passed away a few years ago, Dave Strickler.
Yeah.
All saddened by that. This is a beautiful car. I mean, this is a Concours automobile.
Yeah, it's got the window sticker still in the window. That's pretty cool.
I think Dave Strickler was from York, Pennsylvania, was he not?
Yes, sir. Shut down. We just found out that our ambulance has had a little technical difficulty under the hood of the ambulance, believe it or not. We need a...
We have to have that, so they've called for a backup. It's on its way from Salem, so I imagine 10 minutes it will be here.
Yeah. All right, well, there's going to be...
As Larry can be seen at local car shows, here at Schoner Chevrolet in Hartville, Ohio, Larry and his famous race car was featured in the showroom for all the spectators to see. They could talk to Larry about the old Reliable and the history of this fabulous race car. Larry also brought out a couple of his other cars for the crowd to see. Here's the local newspaper with Larry and his famous race car as the feature story. Anyone who opened up the Canton Repository's local section on Wednesday, April 6, 2005, saw Larry sitting in his Bel Air. This featured article made Larry just as famous as his car.
Right now, we're standing beside a very impressive looking setup. It's Jenkins and Strickler, and right in front of me here is Dave Strickler, the driver. Several people have told us, anyway, that the T10 BorgWarner 4-speed is rather a light-duty gearbox. Do you think it'll stand up under the type of shifting you're going to have to do?
Well, so far we have approximately 25 runs on this one transmission had any trouble.
Do you feel that perhaps on the asphalt here at IRP that you can get this car in the 10s, perhaps in a warm-up run?
Oh, I think there'll be a few AF extras in the 10s.
You think you'll be one of them?
I hope so.
All right. Thank you very much, Dave Strickler, and good luck.
Thank you.
can't buy Larry's car, but you can buy the model and build your own 1/25th scale model car released by AMT in the mid-90s. Thanks, Larry, for sharing your car and stories for everyone to enjoy. Your generosity and knowledge for the sport keeps the golden era of cars still alive today in each one of us.